Now we'll study vector product or cross product of two vectors. As we already studied that in case of vector product, the result is a vector. When we multiply two vectors, say A vector and B vector, two vectors, when these are multiplied by using vector product, then the result will be a vector, that is C vector, and is represented as A cross B vector. As we have studied in previous section, that in case of dot product, we represent it by placing a dot between the symbols of two vectors. Here, the cross product or vector product is represented by placing a cross between the symbols of two vectors. And you can see the result is a vector quantity, that is C vector. That means it is having a magnitude as well as a direction. So here C vector is written as C into C cap, where C is the magnitude and C cap is the direction, a unit vector in the direction of C vector. So here this C can be written as AB sin theta, where theta is the angle between A vector and B vector. Unlike to the case of dot product, where we have seen that the resultant of the result of dot product of two vectors A and B can be written as AB cos theta, here the magnitude of the resulting vector is AB sin theta. And here the C cap is the direction, where we can say it is the unit vector along the direction of A cross B vector, and its direction is given by right hand thumb rule. There is a rule which we name as right hand thumb rule. It is used to give us the direction of cross product. If we wish to apply right hand thumb rule at a point, what we'll do, we just draw the two vectors of which we want to take the cross product at a single point. Like here we are finding A cross B. We'll just draw A vector and we draw B vector at the same point. The angle between the two is say theta, and we want to find out the direction of A cross B. Then this rule says we need to put our right hand fingers from A to B. Here if this A vector, this B vector, we have to rotate our right hand fingers from vector A to vector B like this. Like if I use my right hand and I rotate my fingers from vector A to vector B, then my thumb will point in upward direction. So here we need to put our fingers from A vector to B vector, then our thumb will point in the direction of C vector, which is the result of A cross B. So here we can see we rotate our right hand fingers from A to B, our thumb is pointing in upward direction. So the direction of the cross product of C vector is in upward direction. This upward or outward direction is denoted by dot in a circle, which is a notation for outward direction. Sometimes say we are required to find the vector B cross A, which is opposite to this. In case of finding B cross A, we'll rotate our right hand fingers from B to A. You just see, if I rotate my right hand fingers from B to A, my thumb is pointing in inward direction. In this situation, B cross A will be in cross direction. This cross in a circle represents inward direction. If somewhere the direction is coming out of the plane of paper, we represent it by a dot. If a direction is going into the plane of paper, it is represented by a cross. But whether it is A cross B or B cross A, the magnitude will still remain AB sin theta. So here we can say this vector B cross A and A cross B both have same magnitude, but they are in opposite direction. So we can say that this vector B cross A is negative of the vector A cross B, because they are having same magnitude but opposite direction. So be careful about the basic definition and the rules for cross product. Now we'll discuss cross product of unit vectors. If we just find out cross product of two identical unit vectors, say A cross A, we can simply state that both of these vectors are parallel to each other and the angle between them is 0. So if we find out the magnitude, it is 1, it is also 1. We multiply it with sin theta, certainly it will come out to be 0. You should always keep in mind that this vector product of two parallel vectors is always 0. Because in case of two parallel vectors, always the angle between the two vectors is 0. So sin of 0 is always a 0. So you can simply state, always whenever we find out the cross product of two parallel vector, it will be 0. So in case of unit vectors also, if we find out identical or parallel unit vectors cross product, it is 0. For standard unit vectors also, we can say I cross I is equal to j cross j and the same is equals to k cross k and it is equal to 0. Unlike to the case of dot product where we say it is equals to 1. Now, if we find out the value of dot product, in this case of dot product, what happens? If we find out the cross product of different unit vectors, say it is I cross j, this we can simply find out by using the coordinate system. So we are having a coordinate system x, y and z, and we know the unit vector in x direction is I cap, unit vector in y direction is j cap, and unit vector in z direction is k cap. So here if we find out this I cross j, the magnitude will certainly be 1 because both are unit vectors. And if we find out the direction can be given by right hand thumb rule. Now we are calculating I cross j. In case of I cross j, if I rotate my right hand fingers from I to j, my thumb points in upward direction. This outward or upward direction is along z axis. So unit vector is k cap. Magnitude is 1, this equals to k cap. Similarly, if I calculate j cross k, you can see if we rotate our fingers from j to k, our thumb will point in x axis, it will be I cap. If I calculate k cross I, this will be j cap. Now, on the contrary, if I reverse the order, like j cross I, that will be minus k cap, k cross j, it will be minus I cap, and I cross k, it will be j cap. Just to remember these things, we just draw a circle keeping the three unit vectors I, j and k on the circle. Say if the circle is clockwise, this circle will remind us that I cross j will be k, j cross k will be I and k cross I will be j. We reverse the order of circle. If we draw the circle in anticlockwise fashion, we just put a negative sign in finding the cross product of these unit vectors, like k cross j will be minus I, I cross k will be minus j and j cross I will be minus k. This is a way just to remember the cross product of standard unit vectors. This we can utilize in an example, like for an example, say if we are given with A vector is equals to 4 I cap minus 3 j cap plus k cap. And we have B vector is equals to I cap minus j cap plus 2 k cap. And we are required to find B cross A. This B cross A we want to evaluate. So what we'll do is, we just put the values B and A. B vector is I cap minus j cap plus 2 k cap. We want to take its cross product with 4 I cap minus 3 j cap plus k cap. Now we just find out the product. You can simply say when I cap is multiplied with 4 I cap using the rule of cross product, I cross I will be 0. So first term will not result any quantity. But when we calculate I cross j, we know I cross j is k cap. So you can see what it will become. It will be minus 3 k cap. If I find out I cross k, you can say I cross k will be minus j. So in this situation, it will be minus j. If we come to the second term, you can directly ignore the second term because J cross J is 0. Whatever result we are going to get is by J cross I and J cross K. If we find J cross I, you can see J cross I will be minus K and this will become plus 4 K cap. And J cross K, you can see it is I cap, so this will be minus I cap. Similarly, KK we can ignore. It will be K cross I is J. It will be plus 8, 4 into 2. It will be 8 J cap. Then K cross J when we calculate, K cross J you can see it will be minus I cap. So if we calculate K cross J, this will be minus 3 into 2 will be minus 6. It will be plus 6 I cap. This is the way how we evaluate. Now we can just take up all the terms common. This 6i minus I, it will be minus 6i minus I will be 5i cap plus 7j cap plus k cap. This is the result of this question, which is B cross A.